Over the weekend, I had a chance to catch up with the Billings Aquatic Swim Club, a club that's been recognized for being one of the best in the country. They've been sending athletes to Texas, Virginia, Wisconsin, and even qualifying for some Olympic trials. Now, right now, of course, it's very hard to get into a pool, so I went and talked to them to see how they're coping with the current times.
The Billings Aquatic Swim Club relies on being together and being, of course, inside a pool. With the current pandemic, swimmers haven't seen each other for over a month. It's a problem for amateurs right here in Billings, all the way up to those competing at the Olympian level.
Everybody's kind of been brought down to base level to where we're just trying to get them back in the water, get them acclimated, and getting them on some kind of training plan to build up from.
And the Stingrays do have some elite swimmers. Ethan Harder and Peter Thompson both were headed to the Olympic qualifiers. Two more were just seconds away from making the cut. Now the trials, originally set for June, are pushed back to next year. But they say that's not necessarily a bad thing.
That's kind of a big wrench thrown into the whole thing. But I think it's best that it did get moved back, because it'd be kind of tough just getting back into training and then having that going right away.
So now the swimmers are doing whatever they can to stay in shape. Typically, some of these swimmers are training 3 times a week for 4 hours a day. It's tough to do a dry land workout that can simulate that level of training.
Honestly, you're asking kids to kind of work out on their own between cardio, stretch cords that you can hook up and get some stroke simulations with, to various different things with weights and med balls. But I mean, you're trying to get them almost for 2.5 hours, 3.5 hours to just go to the basement and get some work in.
Now the swimmers are finally able to get back in the water, but outside and socially distanced at Lake Elmo. Marshall leads 4 separate groups, all less than 10 swimmers, through the best workout they can manage.
There's a lot of unknown variables out here. The other day, the wind was up super strong and there was water blowing all over the place and made it really hard to see. I mean, it's just little stuff like that that changes a lot of things.
The silver lining in all this, well, for one, they get another year to train for those trials. But second, BAC's top college swimmers are back in the Magic City.
We put 5 kids into college last year that are all swimming collegiately in college, and they're actually back this summer training with us now, and a couple are already training in the lake with us too. So anytime they can come back and just kind of set up the future and, you know, set up the next step,